Nigga!
Everybody get up.
Tuesday night baseball here on the show from Chase Field in Phoenix. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Arizona Diamondbacks. It's baseball, it's the show, and it comes your way next. Caleb Smith gets the call for game one of the series. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, Matt, we're getting a look at a guy that's really dependable. Last three starts, ERA just under 3.00, and that's some pretty good pitching. Minimizes the amount of walks, keeps his hits down, and if he can do more of the same of that, he should have some pretty good fortune in this one here today.
So now here is Mario Terrell, and we are set for baseball here this evening.
Terrell.
First offering on its way. And here's a swing and a miss on the game's first pitch, and that's how we'll get started in the Tuesday opener. Well, guys, you take a look at this Diamondback squad as they begin play here tonight. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
Yeah, Matty B, and you know what, D-Ro? Now I guess it's time where you push that go button. You're getting a little sense of urgency. They find themselves in third place, and if they want to be part of the postseason picture, it's time to get going and get going pronto.
Yeah, it's taken too long for this team to carve out any identity for themselves. They're going to have to find a way to get them.
So stepping in is Mario Terrell.
Mario Terrell.
Hey, get your pitch. Drive it right here. Drive it. Let's go, big dog. Hey, let it fly. Ah.
from the stretch.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
Behind 0-2 now.
Hey, can't see it. Drive it like you can. Let's go.
Swing and a liner. And this is going to get down for extra bases, as that'll get one, if not both of them, home. And now confusion here with two men on the same base. One's got to go, and they're going to get an out here.
He's out. Three. That's 4-4. Yeah. He's out. Three.
So two out, nobody on. And that'll bring in the left-handed hitting outfielder, Cole Calhoun.
Calhoun.
He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Lazy fly ball out to center field. In comes the center fielder. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. So 1-2-3 go the Diamondbacks. They lead it 1-0.
I better get ready. She's coming. If I want to keep my life, baby, she'll want it.
Leading off to St. Louis. The center fielder, Mario Otero.
Get yours right here, huh? Drive it up there.
Hey, come on, big dog. Get your pitch.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Mario Otero swings and misses there, so he's down 0-1.
Hey, it's a game of execution. If the pitcher stays right there, this lineup's going to continue to have a tough time.
Now a big fastball, and he's well behind it with the swing.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Now a check swing, and he went around, says the home plate umpire. Tough ruling, but it's out number one. Good time now to check out the Diamondbacks' Road to the Show report, as you see a couple of guys in the upper levels of the minors that have been making waves as of late.
Pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
Have a rip like you can. Here we go now,
huh? First pitch on the way, and he swings right over the top of this one. Nothing in one.
All the makings of a big inning right here. One already left a yard, and the power hitters are coming up.
0-1 count. Here's the pitch. Oh, and this at-bat is quickly moving from bad to worse. It's 0-2 now.
Ooh, wait, that was an ugly swing. I'm sure he's not going to watch that one on replay after the game.
Good pitch right here. Let's go, bud.
Here's the 0-2. And he wasn't going to hit that one with an or. The strikeout, and there's one gone.
For my money, there's nothing better than a three-pitch see you later. Well, look here. He gets him on his heels with strike one, up against the ropes with strike two, and then he KOs him.
Is Mario Terrell. He'll be the one to start things out as we begin the 10th.
Mario Terrell.
Oh, the first pitch. And this one's in the dirt. The 0-1. This one's outside. Quite a bit off the plate that time.
Right here, one side.
And he fouls this one off.
And here we go, you got this.
Got him swinging in the dirt. Ramos gathers it. Throw down to first, one away.
Good pitch there, and that was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
Now at the plate, here is C.J. Crone trying here to plate the tying run from second.
C.J.
The 0-1 pitch. Lifted in the air out to center field.
Three.
Terrell is there to make the catch, and that's a big out number one.
That's going for it.
It took them an extra frame to do it, but hey, they're not going to complain as they lock up a nice road victory here in 10 innings.
Close one tonight, 2-1 the final score. St. Louis get their 30th win on the road so far this season. Reyes Maranta earns the victory out of the bullpen, his fifth. Kirby Yates records the save, his 27th of the campaign. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
For the Diamondbacks, one run on three hits, no errors. They left seven men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 42 minutes. Thank you for joining us here tonight. And we remind you to please drive home safely.
Baseball on the show, and it comes your way next. Riley Smith gets the start for Arizona in this one. Dan Plesac, what's the word on him?
Hey, we're looking at a real solid starting pitcher right here. You take a look at that ERA, anywhere between 3.5 and 4, but I'll tell you what he does know how to do. He knows how to get people out, and he can minimize the damage. He knows how to control the running game. He does a lot of...
Next to stand in is Mario Terrell. The season batting average comes in down in the 240s. First pitch on its way. Throw just does get him at first as he was really moving that time. Show track is going to give us a better look at that play. You usually don't see third basemen show off a lot of range, but he certainly did there. And to complete the play, uncorked a good hard throw across to first for the out. Nice play all around from the hot corner. And now here is Mario Terrell,
the center fielder. Mario Terrell.
Let's go, big guy.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Swing and a miss that time. Strike one.
Good thing he didn't make contact with that pitch. Only thing he could do is probably hit that on the ground. It could be a double play ball.
And the slider is low and inside as he just about got him there.
Wow, that's 40 pitches for him already. This doesn't have the makings of a start that he's going to go very deep.
Price at second. Walton is over at first with one away. Ball. And the pitch misses low and away for ball two.
What has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Now the 2-1 pitch. High in the air out to center field. Marte is there now, and he has it, two gone. He flew out in his last debut.
Mario Terrell.
First delivery to him. Liner toward right center. In there, the base hit.
Oh, make the turn. Round it.
And that runner will hold up at second with two aboard now.
Hey, there's another base knock right there. A hitting streak now up to 8 games.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Well, 8 games. Now, man, we're starting to think about it a little bit. You know, you get past that week, you just know you're locked in. They start talking 8 games. Now you're like, oh, I got a nice little hitting streak.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Here's a fly ball. Well hit. Long run for the center fielder. But it's over his head, and it hops the wall for a ground rule double. So now time will be called as we're going to get a visit from the pitching coach here as he'll hope to settle his guy down. Digging in next, Colin Moran. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far.
Wait for your pitch up there, huh?
And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball. So the next to bat will be Tyler O'Neill. He's got hits in both of his at-bats so far in this one. Terrell on third, Arenado on second, Moran on at first with nobody out. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Scooped up to second for one. On to first, but not in time. It's a fielder's choice and an RBI.
Well, they really didn't have a shot at turning two on the high chopper. They only get one, and that allows the runner from third.
Stepping in for the Cardinals, Mario Terrell singled in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, pressure's off right now. He extended his hitting streak that last plate appearance. Now he gets to get back into his zone, work on his craft, and try and drive something in the gap.
In the dirt. In time, and he is nailed at second. Nothing doing there for St. Louis. But no matter, they lead it 8-2. Set for the start of the inning, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Mario Terrell.
Mario Terrell.
Wheels and deals. Here's the first pitch. In there for strike one. It back up the middle. He's got it. And the throw is wide as it pulls the first baseman off the bag.
And that's what speed does for you. He made the play, but in the back of his mind, he knew he was dealing with the speedster, so he rushed the throw, and he had more time than he thought, too.
And now, right, Nolan Arenado. He doubled his last time up.
Yeah, he did a great job to go down and get that one his last at bat. But I got to think they're going to pitch him up, maybe elevate something in the zone. Interested to see how he approaches this next AB.
Fielded cleanly. There's one.
Come on, get there, get there, get there.
And they turn the double play.
Ball four, take the base. Out. Three. Out. Ball four, take the base. Three.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Ketel Marte, flew out last time up. Two runs, five hits, one error in the ballgame for Arizona. High in the air out to center field. Terrell finds some space out there for the catch to retire the side. Diamondbacks down in order, still 8-2. Stepping in, Mario Terrell. He's 1-for-4 so far.
Mario Terrell.
First offering. Just behind the fastball there. Two strikes now.
I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Wow, was he behind that fastball? Great job on the mound using the curveball to set up the heater.
And they could go either way now, I suppose.
Changeup, and he ain't buying it, 1-2.
I love a well-executed changeup, especially one down in the zone. The only problem throwing it in that situation, you leave that belt high or miss your spot just a hair, and you could have some problems.
High pop-up. Ahmed moving to his left. Makes the play, and there are two gone now.
Three. That's ball four.
Up next for Arizona, Wilson Ramos for his career in this matchup. He's 1-for-2. Hernandez stands at first with one out. High fly ball out to straightaway center.
Yeah, right there. You're under it. You.
Terrell is there to put it away, and the runner will be forced to retreat back to first. Ready now for the Diamondbacks. Tim LoCastro comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day.
LoCastro.
Arizona down to its last strike. Hit in the air to shallow center. Center fielder on the run, and he tracks it down. And this ball game is over.
Well, this game had its moments, but it got out of hand pretty quick. Always nice when you can coast to a 6-run win. Save your closer for another day and let everyone in on the action.
8-2 tonight's final. The Redbirds jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. David Price earns his first win of the season. Riley Smith allowed 7 earned runs to cross the plate in the losing effort. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plezak, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.
2 runs on 5 hits, 1 error, and 11 runners left on base. Time of the ball game, 3 hours and 17 minutes. Thank you for joining us here this evening. We remind you to please drive home safely.
It's an overcast afternoon here in the desert southwest. as we welcome you inside Chase Field in Phoenix. Today, getaway day here in this three-game series between the St. Louis Cardinals and the Arizona Diamondbacks. Get ready for Diamondbacks baseball next. Taylor Widener will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. What do you have for us on him, Danny?
Hey, you take a look at that ERA. That's a little bloated right now. This guy's a better pitcher than that, but he hasn't been real consistent. One good game, one bad game. I think what he needs to do, if he can string together three or four good...
Digging in will be Mario Terrell.
The center fielder. Mario Terrell.
Now the first pitch. And we're in for a hot one. 98 degrees at game time, and that'll likely climb over the century mark before we're all through. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. High in the air down the right field line. Calhoun has a read on it, and he brings it in for the second out of the inning. So the bases are empty with two gone now. And that'll bring up the infielder, Ketel Marte. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Line drive, and that's a base hit into center field. Good work and a pitcher's count to get on base and keep the inning alive.
Dan, count goes out the window with this batter right here. It doesn't matter if it's 0-2, 2-0, he's locked. He has great bat-the-ball skills. There are some guys that just have a knack, D-Row, of being able to get the barrel to the ball and miss it.
Eduardo Escobar standing in. First at bat for him in this one. He was 1-for-4 with a double in the ballgame last night. Ready on 1-2. This is in the air out to straightaway center. Long run for the center fielder. Long run. Buddy gets there to track this one down, and a very nicely recorded out number 3. I think a few of these folks need to get out of the sun. Two complete. Still scoreless here on the show. Mario Terrell. He flew out in his last AB.
The old adage, pitching and defense have been stellar so far. They've certainly kept both offenses in check. The offense better get it going right here, because they certainly can tell from their dugout. This guy is carrying himself with a presence out on the mound. He's got feel for all his pitches.
Wind up and the 0-2 pitch. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, keep that guy off the base path.
Strikes in his last at bat.
And he can't allow the same thing to happen in this situation. This is a big time spot in this game. He's got to find a way to put the ball in play.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
Two balls and no strikes to the Cardinals center fielder.
Hey, nice pitch. Be good.
The 2-0 on the way. 3-0 now.
And how about the uncommon patience for the rookie in a big spot right here?
These have been some tough pitches to lay off.
Wait for a good one now.
Hey, he's right here. One time. Let's go.
Here it comes, the 3-0. And he looks at ball four now. So he's aboard, and you always have to worry about the threat of the steal when he's on base.
As the pitching coach heads out to the mound, I think this is probably just a case of giving your guy a chance to catch his breath, pump him up a little bit, let him know that he's got it under control.
And that'll bring in Nolan Arenado. And they're runners at the corners now.
Don't be afraid. Let it fly one time.
Oh, and he breaks, and they've got him picked off. Thought about going for second, but instead, now they've got him in a pickle. Tag, and he's out as he can't get back in time. Leading off the inning, it'll be Tim LoCastro. They'll look to spark the offense and even things up.
LoCastro.
High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Terrell comes on now, and he has it, one down.
Out, three. Out, out. That's ball four.
Ready to begin the eighth, and at the plate will be the speedy outfielder, Mario Terrell.
Mario Terrell.
Here we go now. Come on now.
First offering.
Ball! That pitch is out.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch.
Hey!
Borderline pitch right there. But as a low ball hitter, you can live with that as long as the umpire doesn't give him north as well.
Liner toward right center. And there's a base
hit. Pick it up, pick it up.
Add little insurance here as the leadoff man is on to start the eighth. Cutting it close here, but he comes through in the eighth to extend his hitting streak.
Yeah, and he was staring at his last at-bat right there, probably his last at-bat. Would have been tough to get him another AB in this one, but he's able to get it done.
Hey, better late than never, and I'm sure when he walked into that batter's box right there, he's thinking, this very well could be my last AB of this game, so if I'm going to keep this streak alive, I'm going to have to do it right now.
Hey, right guy, right place.
First pitch on its way. Strike called. Now the throw down is going to be far too late. That's a stolen base. Here's Nolan Arenado trying to add some padding to their lead in the form of that run standing out there at second base. And he popped him up. Escobar just to the left of the mound makes the play, one away. Now into the box, Colin Moran. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. Terrell leads off second with one gone in the inning.
Hey, I need you right here. Let's go, kid.
Oh, a fastball swung on and missed. And for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Wow, that's awfully impressive right there. The pitch before was really close. Called the ball. What does he do? He comes back with a better pitch and gets the punch out.
Second, two down now, and into bat next will be Tyler O'Neill. Swing and a miss for strike three. Pulled the string on him that time, and the inning is over. So no runs here on a base hit, no errors, and one man left aboard. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Cardinals 2 and the Diamondbacks nothing.
Out. Ball four. Take the base. Three. Out. Three. Out. Three. Three.
to a nice pitcher's duel in this one. Both starters throwing strikes, they worked deep, and both were in command of the game. It really came down to a few key at-bats. This was a fun game to watch.
Pitching and defense game, 2-1, the final score this afternoon. The St. Louis Cardinals rode an important sixth inning to victory in this one. Jack Flaherty earns his sixth winning decision in this one as he turns in eight strong innings of work. Taylor Wheatner pitched well, allowing only two earned, but ends up taking the loss. Kirby Yates earns the save out of the bullpen, his 28th on the season. So that will wrap things up. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our whole crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjan. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, head to theshow.com.
Thank you for joining us here this afternoon. And we remind you to please drive home safely.